Pneumonia, again, another lower respiratory illness, can be caused by different things, including viruses or bacteria. So it can present similar to asthma or to bronchiolitis, but in some cases it can present differently if it's a bacterial pneumonia. You can often have, like I said before, cough, difficulty breathing, but with pneumonia it's not uncommon to have chest pain, and you can also have high fevers as well. This is often diagnosed by getting an x-ray, which we routinely do in the emergency room, and there's different presentations on x-ray. If it's a viral pneumonia, you'll see inflammation kind of throughout the lungs diffusely, and if it's a bacterial pneumonia, usually you see one area of consolidation or inflammation in one area of the lung. And in those cases, you clearly need antibiotics. If it's a viral pneumonia, it's simply supportive care, which may need to be oxygen or just simply cough medicines if you are the correct age, hydration, and then cool mist humidifier at night just to help keep the airway moist so that it doesn't aggravate and make the cough worse. With regard to croup, this is different than the other respiratory illnesses in that it's actually an illness of the upper airway. Instead of affecting the lower and smaller airways, it affects the upper airway, and it causes the same thing. It's again caused by a virus. Usually it's the parainfluenza virus, but the RSV virus can actually cause croup as well. And it causes an inflammation of the upper airway that causes, again, a narrowing. The difference in that instead of wheezing, it presents with stridor, which is basically a loud, turbulent noise when you're breathing in like this. So when you see your child doing that, it can be extremely alarming and very scary. So if they're doing that at rest, even when they're not upset and crying, that's another time when you might want to consider getting to the emergency room immediately or even calling 911, as they may need emergency respiratory treatments. The standard treatment respiratory-wise is a nebulizer similar to albuterol, but it's racemic epinephrine. That, again, kind of opens up the airway a little bit. And once again, your child would need steroids if they presented, you know, in this manner. Rarely do we do x-rays if they don't respond. We sometimes order an x-ray to check the airway with the soft tissue neck x-ray. You can actually see a narrowing of the upper airway that looks like almost like a steeple. We actually call it a steeple sign, and that's a pathognomonic presentation on an x-ray. And sometimes if kids don't respond and we have to admit them, we'll order that x-ray. In addition to supportive care, sometimes children need repeated treatments and have to be admitted. The best thing to do at home for this, if they present with just a barky cough or if they start to present with a little bit of stridor, then you can take them outside if it's a cool, damp night, give them some supportive care that way. Or if you're not able to take them outside, you can turn on the shower and steam up the bathroom. Just any humidified air can sometimes help. But in the more severe cases where they're really having severe stridor and difficulty breathing, they really need to be seen by a physician immediately, and most likely by an emergency room physician, as this typically happens in the middle of the night.